Praise Jesus. Praise the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. My dear friends, Jesus Christ is Lord. Amen. I'm here today to preach to you the word of Jesus Christ. Hoping that some of you will give your life to Jesus Christ today. Amen. Today's message is faith. Faith. Now I want you to have faith in God and not in yourself. The Bible says in the book of Habakkuk, chapter 2, verse 4, behold, the proud has his soul not upright in him, but the just shall live by faith. Hebrews 11, verse 1, and following. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of the things not seen. By faith we understand the universe was created by the word of God, so that what is seen was not made out of the things that are visible. The Bible says, without faith, it is impossible. It is impossible to please God. The Bible says, for whosoever could draw near to God must believe that he exists and reward those who seek him. My question to you today, are you seeking God? If you're not seeking God, you ought to seek God today. For the Bible says, it is impossible to please God without faith. And anyone who comes to God must believe that he created everything, and God in infinite mercy reward those who seek him. So now that to acquire faith is to acquire the grace of God. Without faith, there's no way that you can acquire the grace of God. For God rewards those who seek him. The grace of God only comes into our life through faith in God. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 8. For by the grace you have been saved through faith. Now, what is faith? It simply means to trust God. That's what faith is, simply trusting God. And forsaking yourself, forsaking your goodwill, forsaking your good works, forsaking your good intention, and forsaking your sin, and forsaking your nature, and forsaking your first birth, and turn away from yourself, and then turn to God. And by the grace of God, that faith will come into you, and you can trust God. And so, when we trust God by faith, that's the salvation. It is by the grace of God that you have been saved. Through what? Through faith in him. So faith receives what grace provides. Amen? When Apostle Paul tells us about grace, and then go to talk about faith, and then he tells us what faith is, and how we can understand what faith is. So you see, faith makes God's grace available to us. It makes it so real to us. So grace is God's ability. Faith is man's responsibility. Let me say it again. Grace is God's ability. Faith is man's ability, and it's your responsibility. Jesus Christ died for us. We must believe it, and we must receive it by faith. Otherwise, the death of Jesus Christ does you no good or whatsoever. And so it is our responsibility to respond to God's grace. And we do this by receiving it by faith. How do you think you're going to be saved? It is by the faith. The Bible says in Romans 5 verse 1, therefore being justified by faith. Do you hear that? Being justified by faith, we have peace with God and through our Lord Jesus Christ. That's how you get saved. And that's how, if you want sanctification, if you want to be satisfied, the Bible says in Acts 15 verse 9, sanctify their heart through faith. Everything have to go through faith, my dear friend. Do you want your prayers to be answered? If you want your prayer to be answered, the Bible says in the book of Mark, 11 verse 22. Therefore, I tell you, whatever you ask for the prayer, believe that you have received it, it is yours. That's the words that fell from the lips of Jesus Christ. Do you want to overcome this world? The Bible says in 1 John chapter 5 verse 4, for everyone who has been born of God overcomes the world. And this is the victory that has overcome the world, even our faith. It is faith. It is faith in God. And faith is the million exchange in the kingdom of heaven. It is a kingdom principle. You must have faith in God. Without faith, the Bible says it is impossible to please God. Again, for this reason, the Bible said in Matthew chapter 9, verse 29, the Lord Jesus Christ said, be unto you according to what? According to your faith. Be unto you according to your faith. You must have faith in God. And that is the measure. Your faith is measured of your victory. Your faith is measure of your success. And your faith is the measure of your destiny. It will determine where you will be when you die. So the Bible says without faith it's impossible to please God. So you see, all of these things that grace provides comes to us through faith in God. That's the reason in Mark 11:22, Jesus Christ said, have faith in God. And so it is very, very important that you have faith in God. And today I want you to learn what faith is. Because not many people understand what faith is. And so Apostle Paul talked about the grace of God. And then he talked about faith in God. So the grace of God provides that through faith in God. That's the reason the Bible says in Romans chapter 10, verse 17 through to 21. So faith comes by hearing. And hearing the word of Christ. But I ask, have they not heard? Indeed they have. And the voice have gone out all the whole earth. And the words to the ends of the world. But I ask, did Israel not understand? For Moses says, I will make you jealous of those who are not of a nation. And foolish, with a foolish nation, I will make you angry. So every time you're a Christian, you refuse to believe, God is making you angry. For those who don't even know him, they are coming to him. The same goes to the children of Israel, right? When they move away from God, God brought us in. With the Gentiles, God brought us in. Now we can say, we come to Christ through faith in our Lord Jesus Christ. That's how we come to God. And the Bible said then, Isaiah said so boldly to say, I have been found by those who did not seek me. Do you hear that? I have been found by those who did not seek me. And I show myself to those who did not ask for me. But of Israel, he says, all day long I held my hands. And to disappointed, disobedient, and contrary people. So now I want you to think with me about faith. Because today's message is faith. I want you to have faith in God. Do you have faith? Friend, I want you to think, this is not necessity, this is necessity. Because your future depends on it. The Bible says it is impossible to please God without faith. It is necessary, it is necessity. It is important that you understand the necessity of this message, that you may put your faith in God. And I want to say this, if you lack faith, it is not weakness in your part. It is wickedness not to have faith in God. Because every one of us who does not believe has no any excuse to say that they cannot believe. For what can be known about God is plain to all. Because God has shown it to every one of us. For the invisible attribute, namely his eternal power and divine nature, have been clearly perceived ever since the creation of the world, in the things that have been made. What are those things that have been made? Look at the sun that tells you there is God. The stars, the moons, the universe, you say it. And for that reason, God says, you are without no excuse. And now, Whosoever does not believe has no any excuse. They are without no excuse. Because God has dealt with every man a measure of faith. And so unbelief is a terrible and sinful thing and horrible thing. A measure of faith has been issued to every one of us. As a matter of fact, in 1 John 5, verse 10 says, whosoever does not believe God has made him a liar. So you see, unbelief is a slander against the character of God. It is unbelief that led Eve to that sin in the Garden of Eden. It was also unbelief that locked the doors of the promised land to the children of Israelites and caused them to wander. The Bible said they wandered wilderness for 40 years. Journey that was meant to take 40 days. So you see, my dear friend, unbelief is wickedness. Unbelief send men and women to hell. Unbelief send boys and girls to hell. Unbelief is the greatest sin ever. Every other sin has been paid for. Jesus Christ paid it on the cross of Calvary. But unbelief, my dear friend, is a terrible thing. And that's why today, Slafford, London, UK, I want you to have faith in God. I want you to put your faith in Jesus Christ. Now listen to this scripture. John 3 verse 18. And here is the words of Jesus Christ. Now listen to it carefully. He believes in him is not condemned. But he who does not believe is condemned already. Because he have not believed in the name of the Holy Son of God. So you see, unbelief condemn us. Now Jesus Christ died once and for all. Do you know why Jesus Christ died? That you may receive salvation. Now, if you don't receive that salvation, the only reason why people are not saved today is because of what? Unbelief. They do not believe in him. The Bible says, he who believes in him is not condemned. Now watch it. But he who does not believe in him is condemned already. So in other words, now that you are living, walking around, if you don't believe, you are condemned. When you die, you go to hell. But if you believe, you are saved. When you die, you go to heaven. So unbelief is the greatest sin. Many people today in prison that committed crime. Many of you today are walking around. You have seen different many ways. All those sins have been paid for on the cross of Calvary. But unbelief, my dear friend, if you don't have faith in God, unbelief is the greatest sin ever. And I want you to know this. So you see, Jesus Christ died. Salvation is there for you. But if you refuse to believe in him, therefore, you are not saved because of that. So unbelief is a terrible and horrible sin. It is the mother's sin, the father's sin, the parent's sin, the brother's sin, the sister's sin, the grandparent's sin, all the way back to the Garden of Eden. Unbelief is the same thing. When Jesus Christ, the Bible says, came to his own town, Nazareth, Jesus Christ could not do mighty works there. Because right there, there's unbelief. He's in their midst, the mighty God. The sovereign God is in their midst, who is able to do all things. He performed miracles everywhere you go, but his own town, he could not perform. They limited him because of their unbelief. And God himself allowed their unbelief. So what is telling me and you? If you don't believe in God, God will allow your unbelief. But today, I want you to change your mindset. I want you to make a U-turn and repent and put your faith in God. Where God showed us Jesus Christ on the cross, that we can see him and believe him, my dear friend. So unbelief, refuse Lord Jesus Christ to perform miracle in his own time. Think about it, my dear friend. You say, Brother Kingsley, is he not a sovereign Lord? Is he not a powerful? Is he not glorious? Of course, friend, it's all of those things. But he said, be unto you according to your faith. If you're not believing, he will be unto you. If you believe, he'll be unto you. So you need to have faith in God. Unbelief, my dear friend, is the greatest sin. It is the kingdom principle that you have to believe. So Jesus Christ limited himself and allow himself to be limited because of their unbelief. The Bible says, he who believes in him is not condemned. But who does not believe in him is already condemned. Because you see, they have not believed. So unbelief is not mere weakness. Unbelief is wickedness. Unbelief never comes from the heart, from the head. Unbelief comes from the heart. This has nothing to do with your interracial. It's not an interracial problem. It's your heart is not right with God. So today, I want you to get right with God. Put your faith. Jesus Christ went to the cross that you can believe in God. He stretched out his hand. He's calling you today. He said, come to me, all who are heavy loaded, and I will give you rest. Put your faith, my dear friend, in our Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible says in Hebrews 3, verse 12, see to it, brothers and sisters, that none of you has a sinful and unbelieving heart that turns away from the living God. That's what unbelief does. Unbelief would take you away from the living God. It has an evil and a wicked heart that the people today in London, Stratford, UK, turn away from God, from the living God, because there's unbelief that is in their heart. Apostle Paul says, see to it. Be aware. Be careful. Take it. Take care that it's not found in you. And make sure that your own heart are not evil and unbelieving that turn you away from the living God. And in Romans chapter 1, verse 17, the Bible says, the just shall live by faith. That's the way we Christians live. We live by faith. That's a Christian lifestyle. It is not by sightseeing. It is not by striving. It is not by trying. But it is by trusting. The just shall live by faith. It is the importance of the faith that will lay hold, that will receive what grace provides. So grace is God's ability to be provided to you. But it's your responsibility, my dear friend, to receive it. I want you to see what faith is. I want you to see the true biblical faith, what it is. The first thing I want you to see, the object of faith. The object of faith. That means, where do you place your faith in? That's very important. Because so many people today call faith what faith is not. For example, some people say positive thinking, which is not faith. Some people say wishful thinking, which is not faith. Others say I'm hoping for the best, which is not faith at all. And others, some people also say I'm giving all my best. Those things, wishful thinking, positive thinking, wishing for the best, trying your best, those are not faith, my dear friend. So I want you to see, you get it wrong. I'm not against positive thinking or wishful thinking or hoping for the best or giving it up. But friend, I am here to tell you, if you have all those things, I'm happy for you. But those things are not faith at all. And so, my dear friend, today, many people have faith in all kinds of things and different ideas, what they thought about what faith is. But you see, faith is not better than its object. Some people today have faith in the wrong direction. Supposing if you're supposed to be traveling from East Ham to West Ham, but you are heading the wrong direction, what do you have to do? You make a U-turn. That's why the Bible says, repent, my dear friend. Because if you are going to the wrong direction, you must make a U-turn because you are going to the dead end. You see, today many people misplace their faith. And it's so terrible because they put their faith in the wrong place, in the wrong thing. But what does that do to you? What good does it do to you, my dear friend? If you are heading to the wrong direction, and I'm here today to tell you to make a U-turn and talk to Jesus Christ, and he will lead you the way. You see, my dear friend, many people today around the world have put their faith in the wrong, in the false religion, in the false God, in the false things. And because of that, they miss their way. And when they die, they can make it into the kingdom of God. Jesus Christ said, I am the way. So that you do not head in in the wrong direction, when you follow him, you are following to the right path. He said, I am the truth. That means he's not lying to you. The devil is a liar. And then he said, I am the light. That means he's the light giver, that when you die, you move away from death into eternal life, my dear friend. And then he says, no one, that include every other religion, that include every other person in this world, every one of us, no one can come to God the Father except by him. Only through Jesus Christ that you can have eternal life. So the Bible never tells us to put our faith in things, not positive thinking, not wishful thinking, not doing for your best or hoping for the best or giving it up. But the Bible says, have faith in God. Faith in God. For as it's written, the just shall live by faith. And listen, my dear friend, what is faith? What is the object of the faith? The object of the faith is Almighty God. In Romans chapter 10, verse 11, for the scripture says, everyone who believes in him will not be put to shame. The object of your faith is Almighty God. And there's something mystical, majestical about this. When you believe in him, he makes that way possible for you. Faith is not better than his object. Some people today say they have a faith that can move mountains. No, that's not true. You can't move no mountain. God moved the mountain. And that's why you have to put your faith in God. Listen to me, my dear friend. It is not your faith that moves the mountain. It is God who moves the mountain. Jesus Christ said, have faith in God. He didn't say, I have faith in you. He said, have faith in God. When you have faith in God, that's when you know things work out well for you. So listen, friend, your faith is not better than its object. A weak faith being put in the right place is even more better than a misplaced faith and a misguided faith or safe faith. But you have to have faith in God. Don't get the idea that your weak faith does not count. Your weak faith being put in the almighty hand of Jesus Christ is more powerful than your self-faith. So your faith really counts where you put it today. And I want you to understand this, because otherwise you will fail when you put your faith in one thing. If you read the Bible, you will see for yourself. Almost everyone who is in the Bible, they receive blessing from God, even though they have a weak faith. Only few people have strong faith, but most of them have weak faith. If you look in the Bible, in Mark chapter 9, the Bible says that there was a man whose son was demon-possessed, and he came to Jesus Christ, and he said to him, Master, can you help my son, please? And Jesus Christ said, if you believe, all things are possible to him that believe. Do you know what the man said to him? He said to Lord Jesus Christ, I believe, but help my unbelief. Have you been there before? Because I know I've been there before. Most of us have been there before. So we have to believe. When we believe in our Lord Jesus Christ, we have the faith that can enable and move away our unbelief into believing. So it is not faith in faith. It is not the quality of the faith. It is the object of your faith. It is faith for faith that really counts. The Bible says in Hebrews 12 verse 2. He said, where should we be looking unto? We should be looking unto Jesus Christ, who is the author and finisher of our faith. So what is the object of the faith? Look unto Jesus. He is the object of the faith. He is the author of the faith. He is the finisher of the faith. Faith in Jesus Christ is the object of your faith. That I want you to understand today. When you put your faith in the right person, what is good faith is if you put your faith in the wrong person. Suppose you're supposed to be traveling to London and you end up coming to London. That means you put your faith in the wrong place. You see, my dear friend, many people today have their faith in wrong things. Talking about false religion, talking about those who have put their faith in our Lord Jesus Christ. I want you to understand, because the Bible said in Hebrews 12 verse 2, he said, looking unto Jesus. Literally means looking away from everything else and looking unto Jesus. Do you know the reason many people don't have faith today? It's because they fix their eyes on the wrong thing, other than our Lord Jesus Christ. They look at other things, they don't look unto Jesus Christ. They look at other people, they don't look at Jesus Christ. They look at themselves, they don't look unto Jesus Christ. They even look at their circumstances and their situation, but they don't look unto Jesus Christ. Even some people look unto the devil. They don't look unto Jesus Christ. Are you listening, my dear friend? When you look away from everything else, that literally means, it says, fix your eyes on Jesus Christ, who is the author and finisher of your faith. Your faith starts with him, and your faith will end up with him, my dear friend. So faith is forsaking everything else and put our faith in him and trust in him. That's the object of your faith. You must trust God. Again, your faith is not better than the object. Looking unto Jesus Christ. You know one of the devil's tricks? He will make it to that your salvation. Devil will say to you, maybe your faith is not strong enough to save you. Or maybe you don't have enough faith to be saved. And then the first thing you know, like many people today, they will start questioning their faith. They will start wondering if really they have the saving faith. But you see, the devil is trying to trick you. The devil is trying to get your eyes away. Rather than you looking to Jesus Christ, you are looking to other things. The Bible says we do not walk by sight, we walk by faith. That's the reason why Hebrews 12 verse 2 is very important. Looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. Why? Because devil is sowing a seed of that right now that I'm preaching to you. Devil is tricking you not to have faith in God. Devil does not want you to understand this message, that you may learn how you can turn back to God. And he will say, you know, devil will say to you, your faith is weak. But let me remind you today, my dear friend, that Jesus Christ is powerful, he's stronger, and he's wonderful. I'm not putting my faith in anything else. I put my faith in our Lord Jesus Christ. When you put your faith in Jesus Christ, devil cannot bully you. Devil is a bully. Don't listen to the bully. The Bible says devil come and do three things. To steal, that means to steal the word of God coming out from my mouth. To kill and to destroy you in hell. But Jesus Christ came that you may have life and have that life abundantly. So you have to put your faith in him. Jesus Christ never said, look unto the devil. He says, look unto me and put your faith in me. Have you put your faith in Jesus Christ? Like I said, positive thinking is not faith. But put your faith in Jesus Christ is where your salvation is. Do you know what the name of Jesus Christ means? It means God saves. Jehovah saves. God wants to save you today. But you have to put your faith in him. Amen? And so, what should be your ambition today, Stratford, London, UK? Your ambition is to know God. Honestly, it is to know God. That should be your ambition. It's to know Almighty Jesus Christ and to receive him as your Lord and personal Savior. That's what the Bible says. We are looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. If you look at yourself, you'll be discouraged. You are going to be disappointed. And you definitely fail. But if you fix your eyes unto him, Jesus Christ, the Bible says that whosoever believes in him shall not be put to shame. Have you believed in him? If you believe in him, you can never be disappointed and you can never be discouraged. My friend, my faith is in God. And I hope this message, faith, is getting through to you. Because your greatest need today is to learn of him and to come to him and to put your faith in him. Jesus Christ, it is the object of your faith, is God. The ambition of your heart is all to be to know him. And that's right. The more you know about him, the more you love him, the more you serve him, the more you find out that faith is byproduct of your heart. When you look unto Jesus Christ, and you discover what the God of the Bible is, you find out for yourself. Faith is obvious in your heart and your life. Let me give you some scriptures. In the book of Psalm 9 verse 10 says, and those who know your name put their trust in you. For you, O Lord, has not forsaken those who seek you. This is the word of God. God cannot forsake those who seek him. Daniel 11 verse 32. And they that know their God shall be strong and shall do exploit. And so the object of your faith is God. Not positive thinking, not ambition, not your best intention, not your willpower, or not hoping for the best, or giving it all. Friend, it is to know God. And that's why the Bible said, they that know their name and put their trust in them shall do what? Shall be strong and do exploit. Have you put your faith in God? Have you put your faith in Jesus Christ? Start falling on you again. The word of God is talking to you today. Romans chapter 10 verse 11 says, everyone who believes in him will not be put to shame. And here's the biblical meaning of faith. Not only about the object of it, but the origin of faith. Now, if the object of the faith is to trust him, then you have to hear from him. So the origin of your faith is the word of God. The object of your faith is God himself. You must trust him. And without faith, it is impossible to please God. That's the reason. The origin of your faith is to hear from him. So then the Bible says, faith comes by hearing, and hearing the word of God. And here's the questions. In Romans chapter 10 verse 14, how then will they call on him on whom they have not believed? And how can they believe on whom they have not heard? Now this is a very logical question. And then it says in Romans chapter 10 verse 8, but what does he say? The word is near you, where? In your mouth and in your heart. That's the word of faith we proclaim. That's the word of God I'm preaching to you today. So now the object of your faith is what? God. Have you put your faith in God? Stratford, Newham Barrow, put your faith in Jesus Christ, UK. And to put your faith, you must hear from him. And not only hear from him, but you must learn to listen from him if you want to have biblical faith. Because, my dear friend, you cannot pray outside the word of God. Otherwise, you will not get your prayer answered. In order for you to pray in the word of God, you have to hear from the God himself. You have to hear from the word of God. And I'm preaching to you today, the word of Jesus Christ, the word of eternal life, and that word of God is Jesus Christ. But you have to open your heart and to receive it. My dear friend, where does this faith come from? You can't generate this faith. You can't just clench your fist and grit your teeth, say, I'm going to believe. It is impossible. The Bible says in Romans 10, verse 17, faith comes from hearing, and hearing through the word of Christ. That is what it means. It comes from somewhere else. It comes from heaven. You cannot generate it. You can try hard, but it's not going to happen. So you have to receive the word of eternal life. You see, my dear friend, we have faith today. In natural rain, if you cross the road, you have a faith to cross. You're hoping that car will not hit you. Many of you today take public transportation. It's because you have faith in natural rain. But you can also have faith in spiritual rain that I'm preaching to you today. And that faith, my dear friend, is faith in God, our Lord Jesus Christ. You can't generate that faith. It comes through hearing the word of God. It comes from heaven and it comes down to earth. You have to receive it, my dear friend. God giving you 2 ears. Which is the most important organ you have in your body. Use that ears today to hear the word of God. And that you may be saved, my dear friend. Open your heart. Peter said in 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 1. Look at what he says. Talking about those who have obtained faith. Listen to what he says. Who have obtained faith of equal standing with ours by righteousness of our God and our Savior, Jesus Christ. Again, Apostle Paul says in Philippians 1, verse 29, for it is been granted to you, and for the sake of Christ, you should not only believe in him, but worship, but also suffer for his sake. That is to believe in him. It's been given to you. Many Christians today have different mindset concerning if they have faith, they will go through life. All going to be honey without no bees. The Bible says, through trials and tribulations, my dear friend, will make it into the kingdom of God. Listen to me, my dear friend. Nobody can believe in God unless God enables him to believe. Not only that, you have to believe in God. And to believe in God, you have to hear from the word of God. And so God will enable you to believe. The instrument God uses to enable you to believe is his word. So faith is not like a grip in the dark. It is a step into the light. And you have to hear from that word of God. Without the word of God, without hearing from God, you have no any basis for your faith. I listen, my dear friend. That's why the Bible says, faith come by hearing, and hearing the word of Jesus Christ. Hebrews 11, verse 1 again. Here is the description about faith. Faith now is a substance of things hoped for, the convictions of the things not seen. So faith is not maybe or we so. Faith is assurance of the word of God, the word of Jesus Christ. That's why the Bible calls it hope. The anchor of my soul and the bedrock of my soul is the faith in God. And that's the word of God. What am I trying to say? I'm trying to say this. If you do not hear from God, there's no faith and there's no hope. There's no way that you can hope and hope for and faith for, except if you hear through the word of God. The Bible says, faith comes by hearing and hearing the word of Jesus Christ. Here is the question. Have you heard the word of God today? Yes, you have heard the word of God. I have preached to you the word of God. The question here is this, my dear friend. Have you believed? Because the Bible says, faith comes by hearing and hearing the word of God. The Bible asks these questions. How would they call on him who they have not believed? And how would they believe on him or who they have not heard? Now listen to this. And how would they hear without someone preaching to them? That's why God sent me here to preach to you. And this is my dear friend. And how could they preach unless they have been sent? That's why God sent me to preach to you today. Now watch it as it's written. How beautiful are the feet of those who preach the good news. It's how beautiful my feet is that I come here today to share with you the good news. And the good news, you have to believe that God loves you, that he gives his only son, Jesus Christ. And the Bible says, whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Just quite that for you, my dear friend. Why not receive him today, that you may have eternal life? The Bible says, for Isaiah says, Lord, we have believed. We have believed what you have heard from us. So faith come by hearing, and hearing what? The word of Christ that I'm preaching to you today. Hear the word of God, receive it coming to your heart. The Bible says, with the heart one receive, and with the mouth one confess unto salvation. And you shall be saved. That God has sent his own son into this world. He came and died for our sin. And raised again, he is in heaven, even interceding for me, and I'm preaching to you today. But my dear friend, you have to believe. You have to open your heart. Receive the word of God. It's not far from you. It's right there in your heart and your mouth. With the heart one believe, and he confess unto salvation. That Jesus Christ is Lord, my dear friend. My dear friend, give your heart to Jesus Christ. The man blessed the mighty name of Jesus. Jesus Christ is Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen and amen. Jesus Christ is Lord.